Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through a problem on DFA. Okay, so draw or construct DFA for the language L, which is of the form x0y. Okay, x01y. For any string containing x and y. Okay, here x and y could be anything containing zeros and ones. Okay, so this question is really simple, guys. So this is a basic question that I just wanted to discuss with you. Fine. Okay, so we'll be starting from the question. It is clear that the DFA should contain 01 string. So basically, that's what I have just told, right? So initially, before 0 and 1, you can have anything. That is nothing but x. And after 01, you can have anything, y. So indirectly, they are saying that you should have 01 in the center. Center or somewhere. There could be x, there could be y. So this x can be empty or with some values, and this y could be empty or with some values. But these two should belong to sigma. That is nothing but a, 0 comma 1 or a comma b, 0 comma 1. Fine. So now let us continue. So from the question, you can say that 0, 1 is compulsory. So now first let us draw for 0, 1. 0 and for 1. Fine. So from a particular state, on 0 you'll be going to one state, on 1 you'll be going to one state. Okay, so and remember one more thing, guys. So basically, if you are in a state and you are having two types of inputs, always try to find two separate outputs, guys. Fine. Or even the single output for 0 and 1, or separately for 0 1. Please try the combinations, because whenever you are drawing for simple things, you'll be just denoting one. You'll be missing this another transition, which should be 0. And here, if there is possibility, 0 1, like that. Okay. So now we are just done with 0 1. So if you give any string with 0 1 in it, so 0 1, it will be traveling like this. So let us assume I gave 0 1 as input only. So we started here. On seeing 0, we'll be taking 0 and we'll be moving here. Now 0 is done. After that, you have seen 1. So from 1, you'll be going here. Now you have traveled till the end. So this contains only 0 1, right? So before it, there can be anything, and after it, there can be anything. So now let us update this diagram. I have just told you a small trick right here. Check all the possibilities. So here we are having 1, here we are having, 0 and 1. So our string should be 0 1. So here we have already done with 1. So the rest possibility is 0. So just to make a self loop. And here also, initially we can have anything, 1. Fine. So this is our diagram, q0, q1, q2. Fine. So once you reach the final state, is it compulsory that it should end with 0 1? No, you can have anything, right? So you can just make it like this, 0 comma 1. On any continuation, it will be having 0 1. So if you ask me how it is correct, how can I verify it? So take a small example, 1 0 1 0 1 1. Fine. So it is having here 1 0, here 1 0, here 1 0. So luckily I have just give 3 times. Okay, so it starts here. So let me keep the symbol start. Initially, it takes 1. It will move here. It takes It takes 0. Okay, then we are having only few. 1 and 2 and 3. We are okay. In that situation also, we are having 3. So initially, it takes 1. It takes a self loop and it stays in Q1. After that 0, it moves to Q1. After that 1, it moves from Q1 to, it moves to Q2. Fine. And after that, it takes 0, it stays in Q2, it takes 1, Q2, Q2, Q2. So finally, it is in Q2. So it is nothing but it is accepting. So you may have a doubt. So what if it rejects? So let us take 111. Fine, it started here. So initial symbol is 1. It took a self loop. Q0. It stayed in Q0 only. Hence, this string is rejected and this string is accepted. So in this way, we are going to construct the finite automata or deterministic finite automata, guys. Okay, so that's what I just did here. So if you assume x0 1 y, here 0 1 is compulsory and x and y, there may be anything. So compulsory, I have just drawn it like this. So when we added x and y, this diagram will be like this. So I have just told you that if this question came for 3 to 4 marks, or even sometimes for 2 marks, just try to draw the table and transition, guys, because it's really simple and easy. If they specified only construct, then only construct it and leave it. If they didn't mention and just asked you to draw finite automata, then draw, and if according to marks you manage these two things. So basically transition table on Q0, on 0, okay, just observe the diagram, let me keep it like this. On Q0, on 0, on Q0, on 0, you went to Q1, that's what I have written here. On Q0, on 1, you stayed in Q1, that's what we have written here. So it is nothing but the representation of this in terms of table. Continue. Let us continue. Q1 on 0, Q1, Q1 on 1, Q2, Q2 on 0, Q2, Q2 on 0, Q1, sorry, Q2, both on Q2, fine. So now, using this table, just write the functions. On Q0, with 0, okay, on first I had written here, Q0 on 0 it is Q1, on Q0 on 1 it is Q2, on Q1 on 0, on 0 is Q1, fine, on Q1 on 1 is Q2, on Q2 on 0 is Q2, Q2 on 1 is Q2. So that's what we have written here. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this, as this is the first problem. I just gone through it really step by step and really slowly, guys. If you have any doubt, please rewind the video and watch it again. Please try to practice it with me so that you'll be having a clear idea and easy idea on it. Okay, so in the next tutorial, we'll be going through some more problems, guys. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.